If you have seen Shah Rukh Khan's Om Shanti Om, there's a dialogue in it. अगर आप किसी चीज को दिल से चाहो तो पूरी कायनात तुम्हें उससे मिलाने की कोशिश में लग जाती है. This iconic line fits perfectly for Assam's new chief minister, Himanta Biswa Sarma. For the last 8 years, the only thing he wished and aimed for is the chief minister's chair, and finally it is his. It was the reason why he fell out with Tarun Gogoi sometime in 2013. While in Congress, he was so impatient to become the chief minister that he almost executed a coup against Gogoi, but it was unsuccessful. Many say the reason for the fallout was also the fact that former chief minister Tarun Gogoi wanted to promote his son Gaurav as the possible successor. Sarma joined the BJP from Congress just 6 months before the assembly polls in 2016. That year in 2016, Himanta took it upon himself to defeat the Congress. The battle was very personal. That year, he addressed 269 rallies in all the 126 constituencies. Himanta proved his worth by winning both the 2016 assembly elections and the 2019 general elections for the BJP. This year, he did just one mega rally in his own constituency in Jalukbari when he came to file his nomination. And he still won it for the fifth time by a margin of over 1 lakh votes. Though the BJP doesn't want to acknowledge it, but there has been a power tussle in Assam since 2016 between former Chief Minister Sarbananda Sonowal and Himanta. Himanta was the Minister for Finance, Planning, Development, Health and Family Welfare, Education and PWD. It somewhat came out in the open on the eve of the election this year. Unlike 2016 when BJP had announced its chief ministerial candidate in Sonowal, this time no chief ministerial candidate was announced, leaving the field open for both Sonowal and Himanta. This year, BJP has given tickets mostly to Himanta loyalists. Such has been Himanta's clout that many aspirants backed by the RSS and some new faces preferred by Chief Minister Sonowal were ignored. Of the 60 winning candidates in BJP, more than 40 are Himanta's candidates. So the chatter is that Himanta almost arm-twisted the central leadership to choose him as the next chief minister. Perhaps they also know that he can cause lot of damage to the BJP in Assam and the Northeast as a whole if he was denied the chief minister's chair this time. So what makes Himanta, an outsider in BJP, so influential? First, he is a very popular leader, a larger-than-life superstar politician who's fondly called Mama in Assam. His popularity doesn't depend on the party he belongs to. He's also very efficient. Himanta came out much stronger from the COVID pandemic. If you go by the perceptions, it seems Himanta single-handedly managed the COVID-19 pandemic in the state. While in other states, the respective CMs handled the pandemic, in Assam, it was not the chief minister but Himanta who emerged as the face of the crisis. BJP also knows that as the convener of the Northeast Democratic Alliance or NEDA, Himanta is critical for the general elections in 2024. As Himanta takes over the chief minister's chair in Dispur, most likely Sarbananda Sonowal will be rehabilitated in Delhi. Last 5 years, they have worked together. But Himanta's rise has been phenomenal, and now one thing is for sure, both can't coexist in Assam. So it's Himanta's turn now.